Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to my channel. I'm reacting to a WWE video. The Royal Rumble was on Sunday night. I didn't get to see it with my friends. I like the way everything turned out. I like the way they did the whole Brock Lesnar thing. It was sort of annoying at first, but it was funny at the same time. Edge returned. When Edge returned, I was like, whoa, because, you know, I grew up watching him. So, I was laying on the floor and I got up and I was like, whoa. Yeah, I was laying on the floor, but I was like, whoa, like, holy crap. If you want to see more of my content, make sure you subscribe. Let's see what happened tonight on Raw. It's good to see that he's back. And I heard for the next 3 years, that's even more lovely. But let's get right into this one.
How am I standing here, one day removed from participating in the Royal Rumble? 9 years ago, I was medically disqualified from ever doing this again.
Yep. It's the most saddest thing ever.
Oh, yeah, I had the same reaction. But I refuse to live in a world of what ifs. The second I ask what if, the very next second I get to work making that what if disappear. Yep.
He's so old now. It's crazy.
You know, and over the years,
look at that beard.
I started to feel pretty good. And I asked myself, what if? What if I came back home?
Where you belong?
So I got to work. I got a second neck surgery, and then I busted my ass. I got in the best shape of my life at 46 years old so I could step back in here.
I didn't know who's that old. It's not that old.
So I could step back in here and end my career on my terms. So I found myself in the Royal Rumble. I saw some familiar faces. I saw some new faces. Randy Orton. Roman Reigns. AJ Styles. Seth Rollins. Kevin Owens,
he said that Aleister
Black,
anger.
Matt Riddle, hey, the list goes on and on. And boys, hopefully I see you down the road.
Hopefully.
I don't know how you're going to feel about this. I don't know how all these people are going to feel about this. But what if Rated RKO got back together one more time?
That would have been lovely, but we know by the title how this ended. I thought Edge was gonna say no, and that's why he RKO's him. He's injured again. Nah, chill, don't say that. Don't say that. Don't say that. That's the last thing we need. Oh, man, yeah, they're scared. He sounds like he's in real pain. That's a sad part.
His neck, Orton.
Oh, He has a neck injury. Nah, this is disrespectful. Nobody's gonna help him. How we end it just like that. Well, there is an aftermath video, so I'm gonna watch that real quick too. That was crazy. I knew he showed up on Raw. I didn't know exactly what happened. Now that I see what happened, you know, I thought he was gonna say, nah, I want to be alone or something like that, the RKO, but damn, he asked him, got the crowd hype. RKO. That's foul. Seeing that Curt Hawkins has a rated R superstar shirt on, does that mean Edge heads are back? Because Curt Hawkins and Zack Ryder was right there for it. So does that mean the Edge heads is back? Let me know what you guys think down below. Let me know what you guys think is next. Let me know if you think the Edge heads is coming back. Write down some feuds you want to see with Edge. And until next time, ladies and gentlemen.
I keep telling myself I'm gonna get it. I want it all and everything to come with it. Life asks me to dance and I'm always on rhythm. I gotta get it.